Hello friends, how are you? Today I am going to complete my last lecture on my lecture series. Today's lecture is on environmental factors. We have seen in the last lecture that is about the radiation and its effects. Similarly, the environmental factors are also very important. Which are the environmental factors? There are various factors. But we are going to consider some of the important factors, as that is noise hazards, vibration and its effect, electromagnetic field property and its hazard, and the protection measures. First, we will study here, that is the magnetic field. And the magnetic field always exists when there is an electric current flowing. What are the types of the magnetic fields? There are two known, say, the types of magnetic field: static magnetic field, which is produced by direct current, and time varying or dynamic magnetic field, which is produced by, say, alternating current or AC current. The magnetic induction, what is it? It is the phenomenon due to which a magnet can induce magnetism in a neighboring piece of magnetic material, for example iron, without actual physical contact. Similarly, what is this magnetic field? The region in the neighborhood of a magnet within influence of the magnet is felt is termed as, that is, the magnetic field. Just understand the some of the said terminology regarding magnetic field. We have come across such terms as magnetic lines of force or lines of magnetic flux. What is it? These are imaginary lines, according to Faraday, indicating the distribution of magnetic fields. A line of force may be defined as a line along which an isolated, say, that is the North Pole, would travel if free to move in a magnetic field. And it is such that the tangent at any point gives the direction of the resultant force at that point. Lines of force are always in the form of closed curves originating on a north pole and terminating on a south pole. Now we come across the other term, what we call as a magnetic flux of fire. The total number of lines in a particular magnetic field is called magnetic flux. The unit of magnetic flux is also Weber, 10 raised to 8 lines. The flux with the unit of North Pole radiates out is known as 1 Weber. Now you can see here, say, that is magnetic lines of forces, that is from North Pole to, say, South Pole. If it is U-type magnetic field, in this way, you will find that these are the magnetic lines of force from North Pole to, that is, South Pole. What are the properties of lines of this force? Magnetic lines of force start from the North Pole and end at the South Pole. They are continuous through the body of magnet. Magnetic lines of force always prefer a path offering last resistance. Two magnetic lines of force cannot intersect with each other. They tend to contract in length. Next, we come to terminology, magnetic flux density, which is denoted by, that is, beta. The flux per unit area, A, in a plane at right angles to flux is called as flux density. Its units are Telsa, that is capital T. 1 Telsa is equal to 10 raised to 4 gauss. Beta is equal to, that is, phi per area, that is what we call the Telsa. In physics, the Weber, the symbol is WB, is the SI unit of magnetic flux. A flux density of 1 Weber per square meter is 1 Telsa. Just remember, what is this Telsa? A flux density of 1 Weber per per square meter is 1 tesla. Now, what is this magnetic field strength, which is denoted by capital H? The force experienced by a unit north pole, that is north pole with 1 Weber per pole strength, placed at any point in a magnetic field is called as strength, is newtons per Weber N divided by Wb, or amperes per meter A divided by M. The two quantities, that is beta and H, are related throughout. Say quantities beta and H are related through, say B is equal to, that is say mu by H, where mu is the magnetic permeability of the medium. Term dosimetry is used to quantify exposure. There exist natural magnetic fields. Natural magnetic field consists of one component due to the earth acting as a permanent magnet, and several other small components differ in characteristics and related to reported such influences as solar activity and atmospheric events. Earth's magnetic field originate from, that is the electric current flow in the upper layer of Earth's core. At the surface of Earth, the vertical component is maximal. At the magnetic poles, about 6.7 into 10 raised to minus 5 tesla, that is 67 micro tesla, and is a zero at the magnetic equator. The horizontal component at magnetic equator is about 3.3 into 10 raised to minus 5 tesla, that is approximately equal to 33 micro tesla, and is zero at magnetic pole. Now, there are some magnetic flux densities which are observed at 60 hertz near various appliances, which is found in say USA. Now, for just for matter of interest, say that is the appliance and magnetic flux density micro tesla at distance J, means that what is the magnetic flux that is we observe at say 3 centimeter, 30 centimeter, 1 meter. Now, here for the TV, it is said 2.5 to that is a 50 micro tesla. As distance say increases, it goes on decreasing. Similarly, for say irons, it is also from 80 to 30, and that also decreases. These are the various instruments, say, which gives out magnetic flux density at a specific distance. If the more is the distance, you will find the less will be the magnetic flux density. Now, as shown here, this is the Earth's magnetic field would be vertical at the poles and horizontal at the equator. Today, the best fit dipole is currently oriented is at 11.5 degree from the rotation axis of the geographic North Pole, but this has varied weight, that is the time. Man-made magnetic fields, these are very important. Man-made magnetic fields from man-made sources generally have higher intensities than the naturally occurring magnetic fields. In home and public places, magnetic flux densities ranging from 0.3 micro tesla to 30 micro tesla are produced around household appliances, and about 35 micro tesla near transmission lines. In medical practice, exposure to magnetic fields results mainly from the use of magnetic resonance imaging, that is MRI, or spectroscopy methods for diagnostic purposes from devices generating magnetic fields for the therapeutic purposes. Means the magnetic fields, no doubt, they are also used for, that is the medical practices. In man-made magnetic fields, these are very important. For example, in MRI devices at present, patient is exposed to stationary magnetic fields with intensities of up to 2 tesla, and during examination to time-varying magnetic fields as high as 20 tesla per second. However, most patients are not exposed to time-varying fields exceeding 1.5 tesla per second. The peak exposure value for patient caused by therapeutic magnetic device is of order 0.1 to 2.5, that is the millitelsa. Now this is the same thing as I told you, magnetic flux density at 60 Hz near various appliances, just we have seen. Following 9 classes of biological functions are not significantly affected by static magnetic fields. For example, the cell growth is not affected by magnetic field. Reproduction, pre and post natal development, bioelectric activity of isolated neurons, behavior, cardiovascular function, if it is even to acute exposure, blood forming system and blood, immune system functions and physiological reactions and circadian rhythm. Means these are the 9 classes of biological functions which are not significantly affected by static magnetic fields up to 2 telsa. In vitro study, time varying magnetic fields. So various biological phenomena have been reported in 1 to 10 milliampere per square meter range, but their health significance has not been determined. What are the effects of magnetic field on man? Now we will see first effect of say static magnetic field. Number one, studies involved in workers involved in permanent manufacture unit in the USSR, it is observed that former USSR indicated various subjective symptoms and functional disturbances as irritability, fatigue, headache, loss of appetite, bradycardia, tachycardia, decreased blood pressure, altered ECG, itching, burning and numbness. Workers exposed to large magnetic fields in the aluminum industry reported an increase in leukemia, say that is the mortality. From theoretical considerations and experimental data, short-term exposure to static fields above 5 hours may produce significant detrimental effects on that is health. Similarly, now let us see now the effect of say time-varying magnetic fields, the TVMFs, just we have seen the effect of static magnetic field. Now we are going to study time-varying magnetic fields effect. These fields generate internal electric current. For example, 3 telsa per second can induce current densities of 30 microamperes per square meter around the perimeter of the head. Induced current densities indicate biological effects at cellular level. Biological effects from whole body exposure, for example, between 1 to 10 milliamperes per square meter induced by magnetic fields about 0.5 to 5 millitelsa at 50 to 60 Hz or 10 to 100 millitelsa at 3 Hz, minor biological effects have been reported. At 10 to 100 milliamperes per square meter, about 5 to 50 millitelsa at 50 to 60 Hz or 100 to 1000 millitelsa at 3 Hz, there are well established effects observed. Facilitation of bone fracture reunion has been say reported. The third effect is that it is observed at 100 to 1000 milliamperes per square meter, say above 50 to 500 millitelsa at 50 to 60 Hz or 1 to 10 telsa at 3 Hz, stimulation of excitable tissue is observed. There are possible health hazard also. Above 1000 milliamperes per square meter, greater than 500 millitelsa at 50 to 60 Hz or 10 telsa at 3 Hz, extrasystole and ventricular fibrillation, that is acute health hazards, have been reported. Preliminary epidemiological reports indicated an increase in the incidence of cancer among children, adults and occupational groups. which are the protective measures against magnetic field? Magnetic fields influence functioning of electronic devices and the risks of injury due to the large forces exerted on ferromagnetic objects in strong static magnetic field gradients. For example, malfunctions of cardiac pacemakers and aneurysm clips and prosthetic devices. The effect on pacemaker, both static and time-varying magnetic fields, interfere with the functioning of modern pacemaker, that is malfunctioning of pacemaker at a static magnetic field of say 1.7 to 4.7 millitelsa and time varying magnetic fields at 40 millitelsa per second. Magnetic fields can also affect the functioning of other medical monitoring devices such as EEG and ECG equipment. The third important thing regarding the protective measure is that we have to limit human access and occupancy duration in locations where field strengths are high. What does it mean? That we have to maintain proper distance and proper exposure duration to these, say, strengths of high magnetic field. Similarly, many other important protective measures we have to follow. That is number four, regarding metallic implants. A large number of metallic devices such as intrauterine devices, surgical clips, prosthesis, infusion needles and catheters may have a significant torque exerted on them by intense magnetic field gradients, resulting in their displacement and produce consequences. Hence, all persons entering magnetic field environment should be screened carefully, and if the necessary, they may be prohibited from access. Depending on the weight and the shape of paramagnetic object subject to an intense magnetic field, it can become missile with high momentum. Care should be taken to exclude such objects as scissors, scalpels and hand tools from the vicinity of strong magnetic field source. What does it mean? It means that metallic objects are attracted by magnetic field as if that is there is a say that is the so movement of that is missile with high momentum. Next protective measure is that the use of magnetic shielding, that is ferromagnetic core materials, restricts the external flux lines of a magnetic device. Similarly, use of warning signs and special access areas to limit exposure of personnel near large magnet facilities help to control the exposure. This is very important. Now, warning signs mean what? When there is a radiation zone, we put over, that is the say that is the signs regarding the radiation zone and radiation hazards. Now, these are the some of the say that is the say signs which we put up for the patients. Magnetic hazards can disturb pacemaker operation and result in a serious injury or death to pacemaker wearer. Keep clear from magnet. These are the various signposts which are put up in the magnetic vicinity. Now, just this is the very commonest example of MRI facility. We are also having this MRI facility in the hospital. Now, what is here? That is this patient bed moves freely in this portion of the MRI apparatus, and in the MRI there is a rotating magnetic field and it is having very strong magnetic field, and hence a precaution should be all the time taken to remove the metal objects from the subject's body, and in its presence also remember that no metal parts should be present in the vicinity of this magnetic field. Similarly, now these are the some of the commonest accidents which are observed when the metal objects are present in the vicinity of the magnetic field. You can see a bed is literally attracted to the magnetic field of this MRI, instrument, similarly the wheelchair, similarly this is the very commonest thing which you observe, accident may occur. Suppose assistant is carrying, say that is say oxygen cylinder or whatever it may be, say he is say strongly attracted to magnetic field, and that may cause say lethal effect. Now, what are the general MRI hazards? An MRI scanner creates a magnetic field that is about 30,000 to 150,000 times stronger than the Earth's magnetic field, and it is always on. Remember, hence it is shown in the red line. While hazards to people with pacemakers and implants tend to be emphasized, projectile hazards are most worrisome for us. Within a few feet of magnet, the field gradient can rip steel objects out of your hand. The onset of the zone is very rapid and non-linear. You have just seen in the figure. Objects can reach speed of up to 80 miles per hour before slamming into the magnet or you. That may cause even say that is say damage or injury to the say individual. Now there is the next say that is the environmental factor is vibration. What is this vibration? According to vibration, sound may be called infrasound, say that is a subsonic vibration or sound. Sound of frequency less than lower limit, that is below threshold level of hearing, that is less than 20 hertz. It's called that is the infrasound. Sonic vibration or audio vibration sound frequencies between 20,000 hertz is perceived by human ear, that we have seen. Ultrasonic vibration or sound or ultrasound sound of frequencies above the upper limit of hearing, that is more than 20 kilohertz. Supersonic sound, which is not audible vibration or sound, frequencies of sound that is greater than the upper limit, that is say 50,000 hertz, is the say supersonic say zone. Subsonic and supersonic are not audible. In females, the vocal cords are shorter, that is having the length of approximately that is 15 to 18 mm, and then man that is 20 to 24 mm, and their voices have higher pitch than those of the man. It is well known fact. Now this is the infrasound. Say sound of frequency below 20 hertz are called infrasonic sound or infrasound. If we can hear infrasound, we can hear the vibration of pendulum. This is remember. Rhinoceros, elephants and whales communicate using infrasound. We observe that any speed lower than the speed of sound within a sound propagating medium. Now we come here across one terminology, what we call as a Mach number. That is the ratio of object speed or speed to the speed of sound is what we call as a Mach number. You can see here that is the various say that is the Mach number. Say that is hypersonic, what do you mean by? That is the say that is speed is more than 5 Mach, supersonic speed is say more than 1 Mach, transonic that is 1 Mach is equal to 1, and subsonic that is the say Mach speed is less than that is the 1. Then coming to subsonic sound. Subsonic sound is produced by chipping, riveting hammers, road drills and chainsaw, etc. What are its effects? There are two effects, acute effects and the chronic effects. Acute effects, there are no immediate acute effects from this source. Chronic effects related to length of exposure rather than the physical characteristics of vibrations. It causes reddish sensitivity to pain and extremes of temperatures in fingers and hands. Severe injuries may only be recognized when the blood is seen rather than pain felt. Pain of joints of the affected limb, thickening of the skin over the fingers and the palms of the say hand is observed. Next, There may occur changes in the circulation of hands and fingers, leading to cyanosis and dead white fingers when exposed to cold air or water. Raynaud's phenomenon, a traumatic vasospastic disease, may also occur. What are the precautions? Limit the length of time spent operating this tool. Provide padded gloves, particularly for the left or steadying hand. Warning of working conditions. Design of the tool to reduce vibration, including the silencer for the exhaust air. Now let us discuss now about ultrasound. The frequencies higher than 20 kHz are called ultrasonic sound or ultrasound. Ultrasound is produced by dolphins, bats, porpoises, moths can hear the high frequency of bat and can escape from it. Regarding ultrasonics, ultrasonics are the sound waves of higher frequency, that is from 1.9 to 7.5 MHz at or above the upper limit of hearing, that is more than 20 kHz, which are inaudible. Ultrasonics have short wavelengths compared with sound waves in the audio frequency range. Ultrasonic vibrations are produced in the continuous or pulsed beam by some of the methods, that is, you may be knowing it, that is by mechanical generator, thermal generator, piezoelectric generator, and magnetostrictive generator. A sound with frequency greater than 20,000 cycles per second is called ultrasound. Dog can hear the sound with a greater frequency of 40,000 cycles per second, whereas bat is capable of producing and receiving ultrasonic vibrations. The ultrasound beam used in biological system and diagnostic imaging uses frequency greater than, say, 1 million to 20 million cycles per second. The ultrasound has a wide range of medical applications. They are used for cardiac and vascular imaging, imaging of the abdominal organs, in utero imaging of the developing fetus. Ongoing technological improvements continue to expand the use of ultrasound for many applications. For example, say cancer imaging, musculoskeletal imaging, and ophthalmology. What are the effects of ultrasonics? There occur certain physical changes due to absorption of ultrasonics. First, it is observed temperature effect. Two types of temperature changes occur in absence of cavitation. A cavitation effect is produced by ultrasonic. A periodic temperature changes associated with condensation and rarefaction is observed. A steady temperature rise is associated with the absorption of acoustic energy. Temperature changes are negligible to produce biological effects. We also observe pressure variation. Experimental studies reveal that a beam of 35 watts per centimeter square produces a pressure change up to 10 atmosphere. As the sound wave moves through the tissues, the regions of compression and rarefaction causes pressure differences in adequate regions of the tissues. Stretching occurs in this region. If stretching exceeds the elastic limit of the tissue, tearing may also result. Hence, eardrum can be ruptured by very intense sounds. Intense ultrasonic waves can change water into H2 and H2O2 can rupture DNA molecules. Ultrasonics also produce the biological effects. Number one, it can produce heating effect. When ultrasonic waves pass through solid or liquid, heat is produced. Same effect is produced in living tissue. It can also produce paralytic effect. Men exposed chronically to ultrasonics lose ability to concentrate and may suffer loss of equilibrium. Exposure to high intensity ultrasonics produce paralysis in the hind limbs of the frog. It is one observation. Pain in the parts of the body exposed to the direct beam. Ears, tinnitus, dizziness, noise is observed. Nausea, headache, fatigue, irritability is also observed. Very interesting effect is that blood vessel occlusion and coagulation may occur. The heat generated by focus ultrasound can be used for hemostasis, for example, to control internal bleeding by thermally closing wounded blood vessels. There can also occur tissue destruction. Tissue destruction is one of the most common applications of focus ultrasound. By utilizing either thermal energy to induce the denaturation of proteins or mechanical energy to destroy tissue using stress, focus ultrasound can be used to treat many diseases. Increased vascular permeability can be also produced by use of ultrasonic. Physiological barriers exist between interior of blood vessels and their surrounding tissue, which can limit delivery of drugs to their intended targets. Focus ultrasound can reversibly increase the permeability of the blood vessel walls, thereby temporarily allowing drugs to pass through them and into the surrounding tissue. Focus ultrasound can induce vasoconstriction and vasodilation in blood vessels. It can also cause clot crisis. Focus ultrasound, either alone or enhanced by micro bubbles and or thrombolytic agents, can dissolve blood clots. Ultrasound energy causes vibration that can either break the clot apart directly via disruption of fibrin matrix or make it more susceptible to effects of thrombolytic agents. In preclinical studies, researchers have shown the feasibility of treating both ischemic and hemorrhagic stroke as well as inducing reperfusion of occluded blood vessels. Next environmental factor is that is noise. We know what you mean by the noise. What are the effects of noise which are produced? They are produced first on auditory system. It can cause partial loss of hearing and interference with understanding. Displacement of bones, that is especially ossicles in the middle ear, it is observed. Disruption of some of the parts of the cortex, mean the organ of corti. Hearing loss is proportional to duration of exposure. Excessive noise interferes with reception of audible information and thus irritation is aroused. It can also cause emotional disturbances like annoyance, irritation, quarrelsomeness, loss of attention and other factors which are disturbing. During exposure, it is observed that leukopenia is caused, which is followed by leukocytosis after a stress period is observed. It causes increase in secretion of ACTH, corticoids, aldosterone, depressed thyroid activity. It also increases catecholamine secretion. People working in high noise level become hypersensitive. Their digestive gland in stomach and duodenum may develop ulcer. In females, it causes early menstruation and disturbances in the reproductive cycle. Developing fetus is affected and ill effects are reflected in later life. It also affects the cardiovascular system, cause increase in blood pressure, degenerative changes in myocardium, vasoconstriction, left ventricular hypertrophy. It can also affect the vision. It causes a diminished eye vision, which is transitory, and reduced vision after 6 months. It also causes the effect on the skin, causes changes in the electrical potential. Noise reduces pain sensation. Noise causes disturbances in sleep and it affects physical and mental health, that is in man. Ability of sound discrimination is reduced. Noise principally affects human performance in tasks requiring communication. Noise can make it more difficult to learn certain kinds of dexterity. Other physiological effects are also observed. Feeling of vibration in head, movement of the air in the nose, loss of equilibrium, vibration of eyeballs may cause disturbances in vision. There may be some heating of skin also occur. Regarding the vibrations, these are nothing but oscillations of various frequencies of materials which may induce sound but influence biological systems mostly by direct contact are called as vibrations. It concerns induction of oscillations in the human body by vibrating tools, devices, vibrating seats of tractors, trucks, cars, etc. Generally, the human body becomes vibrated through contact with a vibrating solid object, standing or sitting on it or holding it, etc. Fundamental resonance frequency of human body is about 5 Hz. Human can detect a vibration of 200 Hz with an amplitude of 0.1 micrometer. The sensibility of insects and spiders can be several orders greater than human beings. What are the physiological effects caused by vibration? High-intensity vibrations in animals cause damage, with the maximal damage at the resonant frequency of the organs of the body parts involved. At low frequency, heart rate and blood pressure increases, but blood pressure decreases at frequency of 10 to 20 Hz. Moderate vibration levels do not produce significant effect on blood, kidney or endocrines. Tidal volume increases but is maximum at 5 to 7 Hz. Both hyperventilation and respiratory rate increases and vital capacity shows slight decrease at 5 to 7 Hz. Vibrations generate muscular reflexes with protective function causing extensors to shorten. Increased fatigue causes these reflexes to diminish or to disappear. Vibrations also affect vision. Vibration impairs the visual efficiency of, say, drivers and increases the risk of accident. Visual acuity becomes poorer and image in the visual field becomes blurred and unsteady. Visual power is not affected by vibrations below 2 Hz. Optical aberrations appear at 4 Hz and are greatest in the range of 10 to 30 Hz. Vibrations of 50 Hz and an increase at oscillatory acceleration of 20 meter per second square reduce visual acuity by half. Vibrations also affect skills. Strong vibrations impair performance in various psychomotor tests. Marked decline in manual skill is observed. It also affects the driving test. Psychophysiological effects on driving test have shown that efficiency is impaired at around 4 Hz. Errors increase when the acceleration in the order of, say, 0.5 meter per second square, it makes the errors positively more dangerous. It can also affect equilibrium ability. Vibration interferes with equilibrium ability with lot of variation in individuals. Higher frequencies, that is say about 40 to 20 Hz, primarily affect voluntary muscle tone, head sensation, speech, the urge to defecate and micturition. The chest pain, abdominal pain, lumbosacral pain and general discomfort tends to occur between 5 to 10 Hz. Whereas the respiration, dyspnea were primarily observed at very low frequencies, around 2 Hz. In general, it appears that frequencies below 10 Hz affect organ tissue complexes of chest and abdomen, whereas frequencies above 10 Hz primarily really affect the organ tissue complex located in the periphery. Now, this is the say frequency, that is of say, that is the various parts in our body.